optimized tri-index for main memory database systems, and Robert Binner will be giving the talk.
Hello, everybody. My name is Robert Binner from the University of Innsbruck. And today I will present a work on HOT, which is a height optimized tri-index for main memory index structures, for main memory database systems. It's joint work done with Eva Zangerle, Martin Pichl, and Günter Sprecht from University of Innsbruck, and with Victor Leis from the TU Munich. So what is the motivation behind our work? B-trees have been the prevailing index structures for disk-based database systems. They have a good average tree height because they are balanced, as we all know. So you know your access times, you have guaranteed performance, and so they are quite good. But however, latest research in main memory database systems have shown that tri-based index structures like ART, MasTree, can really achieve great performance. So why is this? It's because they have good internal search performance, because they only have to calculate from the addressed bits what node and child they want to address. They require less space per key. So this is quite good. What is bad? Bad is that they are highly vulnerable to non-uniform data distributions. And this can lead to large tree heights and therefore degrading performance and increased memory consumption. So what is our goal? Our goal is to get the best of both. We want to have a height-optimized tri, which has some balanced behavior which is similar to B-trees. So the idea is doing something like this. We take a tri, which is on the left side, and make it more look like a B-tree on the right side, and thereby shrinking it down. So before I go into the details of HOT, I will introduce some background which have prior tri optimizations. So I will take this example, which stores data sets of 10 keys. Each key has 6 bits. And initially we have a binary tri, which on each level looks at a single bit and decides whether it goes left and right. So far so good, but it's quite high and it's quite sparse. In our case, the number of levels highly depend on the number of bits of the keys. So what is the way to go to improve on this? The way to go is to consider more bits at each node. The number of bits considered at each node is called span, and for our example, we choose a span of 2 bits. So the optimization does the following. It combines these binary tri nodes with a fanout of 2 into nodes of fanout 4. However, we can see that there are lots of empty spaces there, and the fanout is not really optimal. So what can we do more? Traditionally, we can omit all nodes which have only a single child, which is a classical Patricia optimization. However, this optimization is in contrast to a classic this increasing of the span, because when we increase the span, the chance that we get a node which has at least two entries gets even higher. So, but can we do something more about this problem with this empty space and wasted space? Yeah, we can. We apply the art optimization and thereby adapting our nodes to the actual size, to their actual content. So with this, we get tri-structures which, for uniformly distributed data, have a high average fan-out and a low tree height. On the other hand side, we have shown with these optimizations we can somehow deal with the memory consumption, but in the non-uniform distributed case, we still have a low average fan-out and a large tree height. In our example, although we have a maximum fan-out of 4 for our nodes, we get a maximum we get an average fan-out of 2. So memory consumption throughput highly depend on the actual data distribution. So can we do better? Yeah, we can. We can use our approach hot. But how does it work? We again start with the same binary tri structure. But instead of increasing the span on a static level, we use the dynamic span approach. And therefore, we first apply a Patricia optimization, which omits all nodes having only a single child. Thereby, our structure resembles a full binary tree with the number of inner nodes for n entries is n minus 1. So far, nothing new. But what is interesting about this in this case is that on each level we have we consider different bits, and bits on the same tree level may not be the same bit. But now the idea of hop comes into play. We want to combine multiple nodes until a specific fanout k is reached. So what does it mean? We get these nice yellow boxes here, and each yellow box resembles a single node. So we get, in this case, a two-level tree structure with the internal nodes being binary Patricia tries. And what we are doing next is we flatten our layout. So thereby, we get actual, you can see this two-level layout better, and we see that on each node, a different number of bits are considered. So we have really a dynamic span. So what does characteristics give this us? So it results in adapts to the data distribution. It results in a low tree height, a good average node fan out. And what we will present next is it will give good space efficiency and good performance. How do we construct this this partitioned tree, so to say? We therefore incrementally adapt our compound nodes on each insert, and we only do it along the path of the insertion, so we can still have O log n insertion performance. And we fill our nodes until we reach k entries. And then we split our nodes at the center, so creating a new node. And depending on if you have space below us, we either pull it up and create a new road, or we push an intermediate node in there. But due to time restrictions, details can be seen tomorrow at the poster session. So what is the impact on the dynamic span and of the height? So we compared the average tree height for a data set of 50 million URLs, having each about 55 bytes, and we compared it with a static span approach, and we took ART, which has a span of 8, so maximum fan out of 256, and we compared it with different variations of HOT. So our first approach is we take a HOT with only a maximum fan out of 8, and we're able to reduce the tree height from 27 or 26 to about 20. So quite okay, but not good. When, by increasing the maximum fan out to 32, we reach an average tree height for this particular case to 7. And by increasing the maximum fan out even more, so we have the theoretical maximum same maximum fan out as art, we reach an average 3 out of 4. So, but how did we implement this actually? We, for design decisions, we took a maximum fan out of 32. The reason is we use a linear node layout and thereby highly facilitated SIMP-based optimizations. And as the AVX2 instruction set allows SIMP size of 32, we took 32. We have exploited the PMI-I2 CPU instruction extensions, use adaptive node types depending on the number of bits considered per node. We use copy and write to get a concurrent implementation which uses ROX synchronization protocol. And due to time constraints, the details can be seen in the poster session. Oops. So we did also an evaluation. We evaluated our data structure in terms of throughput, memory efficiency, and scalability. We used different data sets, we used random integers, we used graph data encoded as integers, we used URLs about average lengths of 55 bytes, we used emails with about 23 bytes in average, and each data set had a size of 50 million keys. We compared it against the index structures ART, MASTree, and the SDXP tree. For the single threaded, we used 6 different workloads based on the YCSP benchmarks, and for multi-threaded, we had different combinations of insert, lookup, and scans. So for the lookup performance, in the URL case, we have achieved much better results than the other index structures. For the random integers, we are on the same level as ART, so to say. For both, we achieve peak performance. On the insert case, for the string data, we still achieve this peak performance. However, in the integer case, we are about 1/3 slower than ART. The reason is that random integers essentially is uniformly distributed data and therefore the sweet spot of this index structure. And we have only a fan out of 32 in contrast to 256. So what's more interesting is the memory efficiency of HOT. We can see here that for all workloads and for all data sets, we achieve only we only require the half amount of memory. And what's more important here is that regardless if it's the URL data set or the integer data set, our memory requirement is within a 23% boundary. So it's quite consistent and it's predictable. And what's also interesting is the concurrency and scalability. And we have shown that for a HOT implementation is possible, which linearly scales, which is similar to the other compared index structures, and therefore quite good. So we come to a conclusion. We've shown that it's possible to create general purpose index structures using tries, which are robust against non-uniformly distributed data. We reduce the tree height, get a great memory efficiency, high performance, and we've shown that the sophisticated node design achieves good scalability. And what's also nice, we made our source code available online under a very permissive license, so feel free to play around with it. And also, what's nice is HOT, although these features are quite cool. So thank you for your attention, and don't hesitate to ask.
So you talked about optimizing for SIMD and various other things, but you didn't measure the, you didn't mention the cache. Did you optimize for cache performance?
Yeah.
Can you say more about that?
The idea is we prefetch.
Thanks. The idea is that we prefetch the data in before we actually exit the nodes. So depending on the actual node type, it, the index part in the node is about roughly 4 cache lines. So if we prefetch this in advance, we can highly optimize use this SIMD and BitTwin link stuff. So we optimize it for cache efficiency. Sure.
The next presentation is titled The Data